Hi guys, in this video, let's see how to convert a pencil drawing to a digital painting. Let's start by drawing a flower. It's just a rough sketch, as I just wanted to show you the technique that I follow. Now the flower is completed, let's take a good quality picture of the flower. I'll be using Wacom graphic pen tablet for the digital painting. Let's open the Photoshop software. If you're not having Photoshop, nothing to worry. There are many free software for digital painting. I will give the link in the description, or you can install the trial version of the Photoshop and try this. After opening the photo, first thing is to remove the paper marks and make the flower as a separate layer in the Photoshop. This gives the flexibility to paint the flower and background independently. Make the pick desaturated and increase the contrast. Then we will select the flower using color range selection tool. Zoom in the picture, select the outline of the flower. Choose many selection points so that the whole range of the flower outline is covered. Play with the sliders. Once satisfied with the selection, click OK. Then press Ctrl+Shift+J to make the selection as a new layer. The flower is removed from the background. Create a new layer as a background and change the background color so that we can maintain some contrast while we start painting. Now we will remove the paper artifacts that were selected along with the flower. Use the eraser tool to clean it. Or select the area using any selection tool and erase it. We will paint the broken outline of the flower using the paintbrush with 100% hardness. Once satisfied, we will paint the petals. One can use the paintbrush to paint manually. Or I will show you the easy method. We will use the paint bucket tool. Choose the color you want, touch the petal, it will automatically fill the selected foreground color. It will fill paint inside any closed outline like each petal. This is the reason why we joined the broken lines of the petal before using the paint bucket tool. If you want to add gradient to the petals, select the foreground and background colors. First, select the petal using the quick selection tool. Then drag the gradient tool on it. If you don't select each petal, the gradient will be applied to the whole picture. Let's now do it to each petal one by one. Select the petal first, then apply gradient. Select the petal and apply gradient, and so on.
Let's use the same gradient tool for painting the center part of the flower. Choose the foreground and background color before using the gradient, as said before. Now create a new layer and we will add some details to the petals using the brush tool. Play with the dark and brighter shades of the petal color for bringing out the details of the petal. Spend some time here. Add some shadows to the second layer of the petals so that it looks natural. Create a new layer and we will draw the seeds in the center. Choose a brush tool with full hardness. Select the appropriate size of the brush. Double click on the layer to open the layer style. Select the stroke option. Play around with the settings for a good looking stroke. Then use the brush tool to paint the seeds. Paint the seeds completely in the center of the flower. As you go to the periphery, decrease the brightness of the seed so that it has some gradient. Make a merged layer of the flower by pressing Ctrl, Alt and E. Then group the flower layers by selecting the layers and pressing Ctrl and G. This will make your painting and editing easier. It's just a personal choice. Now select the flower using the Object Selection tool. Click on Define Brush Preset on the Edit menu. Choose a name and now the brush preset has been created. Now you can use this brush to paint as many flowers as you want. And you can paint it again. I will show you more easier way. First is to select the flower and then duplicate it by pressing Ctrl J. Make as many flowers as you want. Then use the transform tool by pressing Ctrl and T to change the rotation size, and you can also flip it so that it doesn't resemble the original flower. We will increase the canvas size so that we can draw some background. Now let's paint the stem and leaves. Rearrange the layers and use Gaussian blur to have some depth effect. We will draw the background. First, we will start with some shrubs. Then mountains. Then we will apply the gradient to have the orange glow of the sky. Thank you. and at last we'll draw the sunrise. Then apply Gaussian blur to the background so that we will have some depth effect. Do some basic adjustment so that the painting pops out a bit. Yes, that's it. This is the completed digital painting of the flower. Now if you want to change the color of the petals, it's easy. Just create a new layer. Change the blending mode to color or color burn and paint the color you want. Just see how the color changes from white to orange. So that it resembles a sunflower. But wait, something is missing in the painting. Oh yeah, let's draw some bees. It will add some beauty to the painting. After finishing one bee, copy the layer and transform it, same as you did to the flowers. The last bee sits on the flower, so let's add some shadow. And also close its wings a bit. For that, we have to select the wing, cut it to a new layer by pressing Ctrl, Shift and J. Then transform the wings to a closed position as shown. Do it to the other wings also. Now I think the pic is completed. It's only rough painting done for the purpose of demonstration. So don't be harsh on me guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you soon in the next video.